I spent $1,600 on this super ultra-wide 49-inch monitor and coded on it for 180 days. Is this monitor worth getting, and are YouTubers correct about the ultimate productivity booster? So the monitor that I have here is, the LG UltraGear 49GR85DCB. And before we get into this, this video is not sponsored whatsoever. They didn't even send me a free monitor for an honest review. I kind of wish they did though, because I spent $1,600 of my actual money on this. So of course, let's talk specs. 49 inch, 5120 by 1440 resolution, 240 hertz refresh rate, AMD adaptive sync, curved 1.07 billion display color, display HDR 1000. So I create software, but we focus a ton on the production quality. So video editing, motion graphics, and 3D is a huge part of what we do. So I'm gonna go through my points one by one. Now the first dislike is actually gonna sound pretty stupid, but the resolution is really large. Now I'll get to the other implications of this later, but specifically the resolution of 5120 by 1440 present compatibility issues in some areas. If you split the monitor into three equal sections, I feel like the windows are just a bit too small for my preference. But when you do half and half, it's way, way too large. Maybe I'm just an idiot and hyperfixate on these things. If you're on Windows, you can use Power Toys, and I use this priority setup by default that has one larger in the middle and then two smaller ones on the side. Usually the code right in the middle with the browser on the left and some other communication tool on the right. Now this one was beyond disappointing, but to be fair, it's not really the monitor's fault. So I primarily use Windows, but also use a MacBook. Plugging in the MacBook through HDMI is just terrible. The most you can do with HDMI is 3840 by 1080 at 120 hertz, or at full resolution, it only goes 60 hertz, but looks really, really blurry. Now, the solution to this is to find a USB-C to DisplayPort adapter, and then just plug it in directly to the Mac. If you have a Mac, just take this into consideration when you buy, especially when you're reading text, you know, code. The stand is extremely large. The monitor by itself weighs 26.5 pounds. And with the stand, it weighs 32.5 pounds, a 6-pound stand. This is a beefy monitor, but the stand does do a good job at keeping it sturdy, but the issue is that it's very long. So I bought this monitor for $1,600 brand new. For a monitor like this, it's not bad. I think now you can even get the Samsung G9s for like $1,000 now on Prime Day or something. So it's even cheaper than what it was before. The reason I say it's too expensive is because I just feel like there's such good monitors on the market for cheaper price with USB-C support, curved and ultra wide. And even though it's only like 35 or 39, that extra 10 inches doesn't really make a difference. Interesting. I mean, personal preference. The gamer aesthetic is freaking horrible. This monitor is a gaming monitor, so I know I'm an idiot for doing it, but that being said, it's not like immediately obvious. On the other side of it, you have that like hex, you know, whatever you want to call it. So it's not noticeable if you put it up against the wall like I do. And one of my biggest gripes about this monitor, I keep going back and forth with it, but it's the size of it. And specifically with your head, you're always tilting your head back and forth to look at everything on the monitor. If you're buying this monitor for the real estate it can provide like I did, then make sure you have some other ergonomic products like a chair or keyboard. For someone who has like sleep issues and like all the health problems in the world, probably adding a little bit of neck strain, not my vibe. Now, here's things I did like about it. This monitor has picture in picture as well as picture by picture mode, where you can show multiple inputs like my MacBook and my desktop at the same time. I really like picture by picture because I can have my desktop computer render a 3D scene, which requires basically all the resources. And then on my Mac, I can open up a code editor, but I can also use HDMI since the resolution is smaller. Hot tip, if you use the open source tool Barrier, you can also switch between desktops as if it were all one screen. One issue with this is that it will drop your refresh rate to 240 hertz if you're using that, down to 120 hertz. But honestly, when you're using both, it's not that big of a difference. 240 hertz just feels insane. I've never had any issues even on a 60 hertz display, but coding on a 60 hertz versus a 240 hertz feels like a mountain of difference. The way I like to code is by keeping my hands on the keyboard as much as possible. So when you think of a file, class, or line of code to go to, you want to feel like you can just teleport there instantly, which with 240 hertz, it feels like that. The response speed is honestly a massive W for my productivity. And to be honest, going anything under 120 hertz, I just refuse to do at this point. The image is also really nice. I find text to be easily readable when it's small and when I'm far away from the screen. Websites will look a little bit funky if you put the whole website on full screen or even just bigger than 1920 by 1080, but that's really on them and not you. And gaming is pretty cool as well. I played Elden Ring for the first time and the game was just absolutely incredible. It made me cry, to be honest. I think the ultrawide added a ton to the experience because, you know, with mods, you can get it so that it can, you can see the whole environment through the curtain. It just really kind of like immerses you in it. And I understand why it's a gaming monitor first. Now, for me, real estate was for sure the highlight of this monitor. I exclusively just use this monitor and I'm always using the priority grid mode. I have other setups too, like my video editing mode where it takes up like the right 2/3 of the screen and then a little browser on the first third. There's a lot you can do with this amount of real estate. And I'm sure if you're watching, you already kind of have an idea of what you want to do with this real estate. Now, would I recommend a super ultra wide monitor? If it's for productivity, no. For the price point of one of these monitors, there are a ton of alternatives that are cheaper and just as good. For example, if you bought two LG ultrafine monitors, you would have a much bigger display. Or if you want to upgrade the hertz, then this MSI one is like 32 inch, has the adaptive sync and has a curve and 144 hertz. So if you're a huge gamer and you got your bread up, then this is already an awesome luxury purchase that you can get. I don't think I have to convince you of this. But when it comes to productivity, I just feel like for the price point, it doesn't add a lot to my productivity, having that extra, I don't know, 10, 15 inches of space versus if you just bought two monitors, put them side by side. Let me know in the comments what you would use the super ultra wide for. I'm definitely curious. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe for more Kodun content. And make sure you check out my 10,000 trading buy as well as the 10,000 memes that I trained an AI on. Peace out, coders.